Welcome back. Now for the second topic today, a very talented doctor is here with us. He has actually managed to recreate a functional artificial human heart. We have with us today Dr. Ihab Dawood, consultant of cardiology. Welcome and congratulations, sir.
Welcome.
This is not a precedence in the international medical field, but indeed it's the first of its kind here among our Egyptian medical community. Once again, congratulations.
Thank you
very much. Dr. Ihab, let's start off by explaining, giving us a briefing about the creation that you have made for the human heart.
Well, I started this idea some 14 to 15 years ago when I was observing my patients. They had some great problems with their pumping action of the heart. So they were miserable, being almost short of breath and with some sort of short life expectancy after they developed these symptoms. So in this context, we all think what could be done to these patients, how can you help them? I started to make the idea at that time, and every 2 or 3 months I used to maybe I get out from my desk some of my papers and then add some more ideas to amend the ongoing progress of my achievement. Mm-hmm. After that, I met with one of my friends. He was the head of the Scientific Academy of Research, and he suggested that I do a patent, which was not actually on my mind. And then I did that. I proposed, and then I had a patent which was valid since 15th of July currently. That's how it came, and I hope it still goes on to the best.
Okay. Dr. Dawood, could you tell us a little bit about the history of artificial hearts and how the field evolved throughout the years?
It started maybe in 1948, but it was not a pure artificial heart. It started by just adding some mechanism to drag the blood from the weakened heart and then to propel it again into the circulation. And it progressed every year, and it started in the United States with Professor Denton Cooley and DeBakey, Professor DeBakey. And they invented so many types of machines that can do this action. And in 1981, a dentist had a transplant. Before a heart transplant, he had an assist device for his heart. Assist device is, as I've told you, is like a pump which drags the blood from the left ventricle, which is the most important chamber in our heart. And then it takes this blood through some pipes, piercing the heart, takes the blood to the pump, and then propels this amount of blood back into the circulation. This patient had lived with such a device for some time, and then they transplanted a heart from a donor, of course, someone who has just been deceased. And he didn't stay after that for more than 112 days, actually. He was doing well and better with the machine than with the native heart transplanted to him from another donor. Later on, it progressed, and they produced a Jarvik heart from a physician in the United States. He's called Dr. Robert Jarvik. And still, all the heart machines they did or they invented had too many pipes coming out and cables connecting these pumps to a motor and this motor to a battery source so that it can give him electrical energy to operate all this system. All this system had too many infections, and some patients had died out of infection and not out of failure of the machine, but did some deaths had happened from the failure of the machine itself. Later, in the past few years, 5 years, they had invented another type of machine, which is all made from plastics and PTFE. They put it inside the heart, removed part of the heart totally, and they put this machine instead, still working with a battery, which is rechargeable every 45 minutes. Mm-hmm. They have to recharge it. Like, for instance, they put the charge in the abdomen, and they apply some application from outside externally, and it recharges the battery. Okay. But still, it poses too many infections, and a great problem to the patient because he's carrying a battery and his life is still in danger.
Let's move to the positive advance that you have brought in the functional artificial human heart. Do you want to explain to us a little bit with the maquette that you've got with you and maybe learning the process about the obstacles that you faced in coming up with this amazing and incredible innovation?
Well, the main item, and we have this, let's remove this ventricle, we'll give it once again to the patient. This is the main problem. This is the chamber which has the main problem. This is the left ventricle, and the left ventricle has to push blood against to propel it in this artery, which is called the aorta, and distribute this blood to the whole circulation. This ventricle is weakened. It doesn't work well because of many diseases like coronary artery disease, like hypertension, so many other diseases. When
hypertension.
Yes.
Okay.
Uncontrolled.
Good to know.
I don't want anybody to be scared. Uncontrolled.
Okay.
Because if you control all your risk factors, you have no problem. You can live like an ordinary, intact, sound person. You're not a patient anymore.
Okay.
If you have diabetes, if you have whatever risk factors.
Okay.
And that's what they do now in the United States. That's the new art that they do. So this ventricle is now weak. It cannot get rid of the blood. This ventricle receives the blood originally from the one up front to it. It's the left atrium, which receives the blood from the lungs. The same on the right, but the circulation still goes in this way. It's a one-way valve. It passes from the left atrium to the left ventricle, and then from the left ventricle to the aorta to be distributed. When you have this failure in this ventricle, blood stays here. When it stays here, it stays as well here, and then it stays in the lungs, and that's why these patients have shortness of breath. They have what's called the pulmonary edema, which is staying of fluid in...
Is it stroke? Is this a stroke?
A stroke is an affection of one of the cerebral in the brain vessels, either with a thrombus, which occludes it, or a hemorrhage, which leads to bleeding into
and
the
does
brain.
Does this cause a heart attack?
Heart attack.
Okay.
Heart attack is when the coronaries, one of the coronaries is blocked with a thrombus, with a material that does not allow blood to continue flowing, and when blood does not flow, the heart does not reach, the blood doesn't reach here, the muscle.
Yeah. Yes.
And when the muscle is deprived of this blood for a long time, this muscle gets weakened and we have a heart failure ensuing in the process. Mm-hmm. So.